Photo: Hane Palmer IV, TNS San Diego State's Cameron Kelly sacks Stanford's Keller Crist on Saturday night. Crist went 8-for-19 with 2 interceptions and a lost fumble in the Cardinals' 2017 loss. San Diego State's Cameron Kelly sacked Stanford's Keller Crist on Saturday night. Crist went 8-for-19 with 2 interceptions and a lost fumble in the Cardinals' 2017 loss. Photo: Hane Palmer IV, TNS Stanford's Keller Crist needs to shake off rocky performance. Stanford quarterback Keller Crist is last among the 12 quarterbacks listed in the PAC 12 in passer efficiency. He has completed 52.1% of his passes, well below the accuracy of every other regular quarterback. Following the worst performance of his young career, 8-for-19 with 2 interceptions and a lost fumble in Saturday night's 2017 loss at San Diego State, Crist got the proverbial vote of confidence. Head coach David Shaw said the redshirt junior is still solidly his number one quarterback. "I believe we have a quarterback that can take advantage of the athletes we have outside, both in our receiver and tight end positions," Shaw said Tuesday. But he acknowledged it didn't happen against the Aztecs. The tight ends, for instance, caught only one pass, although another was dropped by Dalton Schultz. Crist threw 2 long on 4 potential big plays, including 2 intended for Donald Stewart and 1 for tight end Caden Smith. Crist bounced a short one toward Trent Irwin, threw low on a swing pass that Bryce Love couldn't handle, and threw 2 low on a 15-yarder toward tight end Colby Parkinson. Worst of all, he ended the final 2 possessions of the first half with turnovers. On a 3-yard and 12 play, he threw into a crowd and the resulting interception enabled the Aztecs to go just 15 yards for a touchdown. Then he failed to avoid a blitzing cornerback, who should have been blocked by Love, and lost the ball when he was sacked. His final pass of the night was an underthrown deep try for J.J. Arcega-Whiteside that was intercepted in the final minute. Shaw said his own bad play call led to the first pick. "I shouldn't have put him in that position, and the quarterback's got to protect a bad play call," he said. Crist obviously will have to play a lot better when the Cardinal 12-0-1 PAC 12 play UCLA 21-0-0 and quarterback Josh Rosen 1,283 yards, 13 TDs, 2 interceptions on Saturday night in their first home game. Crist has done an outstanding job through training camp and practices in addition to the first 2 games of the season, Shaw said. "I think he's determined to come out and play a great game." Crist lost in his second straight start after winning in his first 7, but in truth, Stanford hasn't beaten a team with a winning record under his guidance. Last year, Arizona, Oregon State, Oregon, Cal, and Rice were well under .500. Stanford beat North Carolina in the Sun Bowl, but he was out after his knee injury in the second quarter. Stanford crushed Rice again in this year's opener. Crist worked hard to come back from his torn ACL. The suspicion remains, however, that he has lost some mobility. "He's moving extremely well in practice," Shaw said. He conceded that Crist might not have the same exact top speed. That non-gamble many Stanford fans probably gasped when Shaw opted for a short field goal try rather than go for a first down on 4th and less than a yard at the Aztecs 4 in the third quarter. Shaw typically goes for the yardage with a herd of extra offensive linemen. After the game, Shaw defended the choice, saying his team down 137 needed 2 scores to win. But that rationale applies only in the late stages of a game there were nearly 20 minutes left. On Tuesday, he said, "We weren't playing like gangbusters on offense, and a third down run had just been stuffed. It may have seemed conservative, but at the time, I think it was the right decision." In making it, though, he possibly conceded 4 points, and the Aztecs won by 3. Briefly starting inside linebacker Sean Barton is out indefinitely with what looked like a right knee injury. Stanford doesn't disclose injuries. Shaw said he potentially could miss the rest of the season. The September 30 home game against Arizona State will begin at 1 p.m. and will be shown on PAC 12 networks. Tom Fitzgerald is the San Francisco Chronicle staff writer. Emailed Fitzgerald at schronicle.com, Twitter @TimFitzgerald.